Yes. Good morning, children. This is Pavani, teacher of English for 9th class. Now, we are going to start the C reading homework. Already we have completed A and B reading in 3rd unit. Okay, now we are going to discuss on C reading. Means A reading, Swami is expelled from the school, which is completed. The next one, B reading. Not just a teacher, but a friend also completed. Now we are going to discuss C reading, which is cited as homework. Okay. Now, before starting of the homework, let me give you a small introduction regarding the lesson. Okay. Some teachers or some institutions, they support homework must be there for the children. Okay. Some members, they disagree with this statement. Okay. Now, let me tell you. Tamin Ansari, he said that the amount of homework has been increased since 1981. He said that till 1981, okay, that homework has been increased. Okay, till 1980, it was no problem. Okay, that was just limited homework. Means on 1981 onwards, the homework has been increased. How? In which way? Means before, the student has to spend only 1 hour. After 1981, the student has to spend more than 3 hours or 4 hours. Okay, and he said that. And some people, they said no. Some people said that the homework has been increased since 1957. No, that is not correct. It has been increased before 1957 onwards. It's not nowadays. It has been increased before 1957, some people said. Okay. Now let me tell you the advantages of the homework and disadvantages of the homework. Okay. First, advantages. Okay. And here means homework, which is very useful for the competitive world. Okay. And if the child do her homework, means that will be useful for this competitive world. And next, and this will be useful in the time of college day. Some members said that it will be very useful in the time of college day. But so many disadvantages are there. What are they? And here, disadvantages, if the child spends lot of time with the homework, definitely that leads to mental stress and it increases body weight. And one more, there is no time for the children to spend with their parents and siblings. And next, bad habits such as copying the homework and cheating in the test. Okay, these disadvantages may occur in the student's life. Okay, and here this is the homework lesson. Now let's go to the topic. Homework has been historically been given to students to reinforce what they learned in school and ultimately to help them learn material better. Okay. And here it is an article. In the article, what did they say? Homework has an historical been given to the students to reinforce. Reinforce means strengthen what they learned in the school. Before the school, if the lesson completes, immediately the teacher gives the homework. Because already the lesson, no, if they do the homework, then completely the work is there in their mind. Okay, and if they do the homework, that the subject will be very perfect for them. Means the lesson will be very perfect for them. However, too much homework is not helpful and it can be counterproductive. And here, and they said in this one, however, too much homework is not helpful. Okay, homework will be helpful, but too much homework, which is not helpful, and it is counterproductive. It is counterproductive means here it is very harmful. Means I already told you the disadvantages, and it gives you mental stress, and they don't have time to spend with their siblings, and it is not good. Okay, excessive amount of time spent completing homework can take away the kid's social life, family life, and it limits their participation in sports and other activities. Okay, and here, yes, if the homework is given to the children, then every time the children has to spend to complete the homework. Okay, and the social, they will miss the social life and they'll miss the parents. The amount of homework a teacher has to give a student should be restricted. Okay, and here the homework completely restricted, not abolished. Okay, not removed. It has been restricted, means that is must be limited. Critically acclaimed author Tamim Ansari reports that since 1981, the amount of homework given to average 6th class child has increased by more than 50%. Okay, and only for 6th class, they did not talk about 7th and 8th. Okay, to compare the 6th, 7th class, and they have some homework. Okay, 8th class, the subjects also will be increased. Okay, and here just they said that about 6th class children. Okay, and yes, where did I stop? Yes, the amount of homework given to an average 6th class child increased by more than 50%. Okay, 50% homework has been increased. Before, they have spent with the homework just 1 hour. Okay, now they are spending their time more than 2 hours or 3 hours. Many people claim that increases in homework dates as back as 1957. No, no, it is not before 1981. It has been there. The homework is there before 1957. This, the new computation that emerged served as an incentive for schools to try to increase the volume of the curriculum. Okay, and here. Nowadays, okay, it's the competitive world. Okay, yes, in the competition, they emerged to serve incentive for schools try to increase the volumes. Okay, and here some other schools, they are putting the another syllabus like IIT and NEET. So such syllabus they have included in their syllabus. Okay, it is not good because they have to carry all those books. Okay, which affects the children. The amount of homework increases with their increases in class. Okay, and here if the homework increases and they have to carry lots of books. Many teachers defend the large amount of homework, claiming that it helps to prepare student for world that is becoming increasingly competitive. Yes, here, and some teachers defended, which means supporting what they are telling, how. Like they are supporting, yes, nowadays it is the competitive world, so it is very useful for the children. Some teachers supported that homework. However, Dr. Krelovec, author The End of Homework. Here, the author Krelovec is the author of the book which names The End of Homework. Okay, that is the book name. Okay, in the book he wrote about homework, okay, which is good or not. Yes, he argues that doing homework during high school has little or no effect on successful study skill of the student when they join in college. Okay, I already told you, know the some teachers supports that it is useful for the next college or university. Okay, some students, some teachers supports that, but here in his book, what is the book name? The End of Homework. What did he say? He argues. Who is that? The Krelovec argues that doing homework during the school has little or no effect on college days. Okay, it will no effect. The homework will not show any good result in the time of college days. He said. Excessive amount of homework can be harmful to kids both physically and mentally. Okay, I already told you, and this is the disadvantage for the children. If the large amount, excessive homework given to the children, it gives definitely mental stress and physical stress, and physically they will be spoiled. Okay, a lot of homework usually means a lot of books to carry. Means they have to bring all those books. It means the Telugu, science, social, English, maths, the 5 homeworks has been given. means tomorrow morning they have to bring all those homeworks. Okay, means yes, yes, a lot of homework usually means a lot of books to carry. They have to bring all those books to the class. 55% of the Massachusetts an institution in the USA children, as per the survey by researchers of Simmons College, carry loads heavier than 50% of their body weight, which is suggested limit. Okay, already they said the books to be carried only in limited way. Okay, but the children carry more than 50% of their body weight. Okay, the survey was done in the Simmons College. Okay, it's not good for the children. More than 50% they are carrying. What happened if they carry like that? Carrying large amount of weight daily at a young age can do a lot of damage because bones are still in development stage. Okay, and here the bones are in still development stage. Okay, and that effect can go to the bones. Okay, if they carry lots of books. The U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission has reported that in 1999, more than 800 kids were treated in emergency ward for backpack related injuries. Okay, means already survey was done. Okay, for in the survey, okay, 800 children were treated for backpack injuries like backbone and completely and nerves pain, okay, and neck pain. They're suffering, okay, because of large quantity, okay, they're carrying in their bags. Many of them injuries can lead to serious problem later life, including chronic shoulder, neck, back pain. Okay, of course. Okay, nowadays in the childhood they may not get any problem, but in the future that problem will be very serious. Okay, their problem will be very serious, and chronic neck shoulder pains, chronic shoulder pains they may get. The large amount of homework is causing kids in both high school and junior high school to be until midnight or later. Okay, and the large amount of homework, then they are trying to do the homework till night, okay, late night in high school and junior high school. Junior high school means here 6th to 7th, and high school means 8th, 9th, 10th. When extracurricular activities such as sports, clubs, etc. are added to the picture, kids may even have to wake up early next morning to finish their homework, leaving them with an insufficient amount of sleep. Okay, means already they are having lot of subjects to complete and homework also there. And at the time, the parents forced to join dance or music and some other activities. At the time, after going to the house, they don't have time to do the homeworks. Okay, and they have to go to the dance class or music class or some other classes. Okay, such as extracurricular activities. Okay, and after that, what happened? They have to get up early in the morning to do their homework, and that leads to there is no proper sleep for them. Some parents and teachers argue that it would be beneficial to child's academics to limit after school activities. Okay, and some teachers and parents, they support that. Okay, and whatever they are learning, music and next dance, that will be very useful for the children. Yes, however, cutting the time out of the new hours a weak teenagers use for exercise could be factor the growing obesity cases. Okay, actually after completing their work, they have to do some games. They have to do some games, or indoor games or outdoor games. And and definitely if they play, definitely their body weight will be completely down. But here they are not playing. Okay, they are not giving any importance for the guests, parents. Okay, and mostly the parents and the teachers giving importance for the homework. And what will be happened? Completely, they are sitting and they are writing. Then the body weight will be increased, and that is the main factor to get obesity cases. The number of children who are overweight had doubled and last 2 or 3 decades. Okay, and a decade means 10 years. Okay, 3 decades means 30 years. Okay, in these 30 years, there was survey. The survey has been done. In that survey, what happened means the children completely overweight, put on weight. Okay. Yes, the number of children who are overweight has doubled in the last 2 or 3 decades. Currently, 1 child out of 5 overweight. Okay, means in the 5 children, 1 is in overweight. They are suffering with obesity. These children are faced with more problems in school. Okay, the obesity children are facing lot of problems. What are the problems? Let's see. Instead of learning and concentrating on their work, many children are developing low self-esteem and even depression because of easing. Okay, and here they have to they coming to the school to learn, but some other children definitely they will tease them. Okay, means they put on the weight. Okay, then some other children they teases them. Okay. By showing other things, okay, like coconut or laddu, okay, like those words they have used, okay, then what will be happen? Their self confidence will be decreased. The cases of obeying are growing most certainly due to lack of physical exercise. Okay, so many cases were there because of there is no exercise for the children. With more and more homework being assigned, kids simply do not have enough time to proper amount of exercise because lot of homework. Okay, lot of homework is there. That's why they don't have time to do the exercise. Homework also takes away the time that kid could be spending with his or her family, rather than spending time bonding and building strong family relationships. Parent and children argue over homework. Okay, and here actually the children must spend their time after school hours. They must spend their time with the parents. Okay, and then only their bonding will be very strong. But here they don't have time because they still writing homeworks after coming to the school. They start the writing. Yes, time is taken away from important aspects of daily life. Okay, this time means that actually they have to spend the time with their parents. No, this time has been taken from the children. This time is particularly precious in families with both parent working, especially one more thing, if the parents both are working, that I mean is very precious to the children and both parents. Okay, they have to spend, okay, with the children, but there is no time for them. This time could be better spent going out to dinner as family or doing other activities that more families are not able to do because the kids don't have time to take a break from their homework schedule. Yes, here actually the parents should make the children to go out to take dinner or another park or any amusement things. Okay, but there is no time because lot of homework. Because the kids don't have time to take a break from the homework, from the homework schedule. When assignments are given carelessly and frequently, it causes students to lose interest in the subjects. Okay, the assignments means works, homeworks. Okay, given frequently or carelessly. Carelessly means, for example, in those days when I was studying, those system was there. Okay, you have to write this question 5 times, 10 times, 15 times, like that. Okay, if it is given like that, what will be happen? If it is given frequently, carelessly, then the interest, the student will lost their interest in that subject. Negative result that can also occur when the student is not able to complete his or her homework. Okay, and here time also not there, and they will lost the interest in that particular subject. And many times they will resort to copying the homework, having other to do their assignments, or cheating in tests. Okay, some members what will they do? And here, if the assignment frequently given, okay, and assignments, and next you have to write 2 or 3 times, more than 3 times, the homework given like that, and what the child do? Okay, and here the child give the homework to his parents or help sibling. Okay, write my homework. Okay, do my homework, help me. Okay, they won't write that homework will be completed by parents or siblings. Okay, and one more, cheating. Okay, and they follow cheating in the tests means copying from the others. Bad habits such as these are likely haunt kids through their lives, haunt adverse effect on their moral judgment. Actually, they have to follow the moral way. Instead of moral way, they are following the cheating way to copy from others. Okay, this is not at all good to give lot of homework. Student will almost always take the easy way when it comes to homework. Already, the children are very lazy to do homework, and if it is lot of homework, then definitely they will cheat in the homework. Okay. Yes, the student will almost always take easy way. Okay, easy way means they will make the parents to do the homework or siblings to do the homework. Okay, that is the easy way for the children. The use of homework effective when used by the rule less is more. Overwhelming kids with loads of homework can be caused them stress and possible physical injury. Okay, overwhelming means here it is extreme. Okay, large in quantity homework should not be given to the children, and it gives physical and mental stress. Homework takes away from the small amount of time kids to spend with their parents and siblings. Yes, I already told you there will be no time for the children to spend with the parents and siblings. Siblings means sisters and brothers. Okay, a limit on their physical and social activities can also take a large toll to their lives and could hinder their health and future relationships. And toil means hard work. Okay, and here they will not participate in the social life, and they will not participate in the means in the family life. Okay, and here their relationship will be spoiled. This is not say that homework should be abolished, but by reading all these things, what did you understand? You are thinking that homework must be abolished. No, homework shouldn't be abolished. Abolished means removed. Homework shouldn't be removed, but it should be limited. It should be very limited means per day only 3 or 2. That's it. Only 3 homeworks must be there. More than 3 shouldn't be given. Yes, these homework should be limited, and homework should be creative. Okay, that homework which is given to the children, that must be very creative. And it interesting also that children enjoys it. Okay, while doing the homework, if it is creative, the children enjoys it very much. Okay, I think everybody understood that lesson, homework. Thank you.